that before, and then now realize it's 4 o'clock in the morning on Sunday. I'm like, oh gosh. So I lay down to go to sleep, set my alarm up. I call the publishing company to cancel, and nobody answers. And I'm like, Jesus. Well, I can't just not show up. So I drive into Music Row and I go to the back door and paint on my best smile. I'm tired. And they open the door and I said, I'm here for Philip White. Like, yeah, he's upstairs waiting on you. And I walk upstairs and I open the door and Philip standing there. And I said, hey, I'm D. And he looks at me and he shakes my hand. And he looks right through me. And he goes, you okay? And I lost it in front of a complete stranger. Still chokes me up. And he just looked at me and he goes, it's all right, man. And we went and we had breakfast at Pancake Pantry there in Nashville. Been there. And we sat down and we started talking about life and talking about things seldom work out the way we think they're going to work out, but they work out fantastic in the end. God's really, really good. You know, our old saying, get out of God's way. He knows what he's doing. And we went back and he said, we don't have to write. We'll do it some other time. I didn't have the courage to tell him I was leaving in 2 weeks. And as he's getting his book out to get another appointment on the book, there was a little piano in front of me and I just started doing this thing. And he goes, what's that? And I said, oh, that's my bitter Nashville song. And he goes, well, I got to hear that. So I sang that verse. And he goes, D, that's, I'm telling you, that's great. We got to do that song right now. And I went, really? And I was like, it just feels like I'm beating Nashville up. We can't just come into it with, I've lived in this place and I know, everybody's going to know. He goes, play it again. And I played it. And guys, I'm telling you, he recited the first verse verbatim. And I just stood there going, oh my God, this guy's great. And I realized it was a poem he had written like 10 years earlier. And it fit the music perfect. So we had the first verse and the second verse, and before we even started to write the song. It went from us finishing that song to me staying in town to getting cut by a band called Rascal Scruggs, is the way I was told on the phone. To it being a single 4 years later and ending up Song of the Year, ACM Song of the Year, 4 years later. Changed my life, changed their life. And it just goes to show you, God gave me the greatest songwriting lesson in the world that day. You don't ever quit. That's the secret, because if you don't quit, you never fail. And I'm going to send this out to everybody in this planet that's been through a hard time and feels like quitting. Don't do it. Faced all my demons, finally content with the past I regret. I found you find strength in your moments of weakness. For once I'm at peace with myself. I've been burdened with blame, trapped in the past for too long. I'm moving on. I'm moving on. Well, I've lived in this place and I know all the faces. Each one's different, but they're always the same. They mean me no harm, but it's time that I face it. They'll never allow me to change. But I never dreamed home would end up where I don't belong. I'm moving on. I'm moving on. At last I can see life has been waiting for me, and I know there's no guarantees, but I'm not alone. There comes a time And all you can see are the years passing by, and I have made up my mind that those days are gone. I saw what I could, and I packed what I couldn't. Stopped to fill up on my way out of town. I love like I should, but I live like I shouldn't. I had to lose everything to find it. Well, maybe forgiveness will find me somewhere down this road. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
Oh, what a great song.
You know,
so much.